So here's where we are right now. The president is firing his defense secretary, Mark Esper. He did that today. And that may not be the end of his scorched earth strategy. A senior administration official tells CNN FBI Director Christopher Wray and CIA Director Gina Haspel could be next. So joining me now, the former NATO Supreme Allied Commander, General Wesley Clark. General, good to see you. Thank you. Is this serious? I see you got your serious face on here when you're talking about these people. The Defense Secretary Esper out, fears that Haspel and Wray could be next. Isn't that incredibly dangerous, especially during a transition?
It is dangerous. It does raise risks. It's demoralizing to the people in the national security agencies who stay behind. Yes, it's very hurtful. And, of course, this is very characteristic of Donald Trump. He's angry. He wants to hurt people and break things. And he's never been happy, really, with the national security apparatus because they've never really supported his theory about cozying up to Russia. Russia's such a great friend, et cetera, get rid of our allies. Well, this is a good way to strike back. But, Don, it also demonstrates his power. This is part of keeping the Republicans in the Senate cowed. It's part of keeping the focus on Donald Trump and his power in the news media as he goes out of office. So he doesn't look like he's cowering in the White House. No, no, he's in charge. He's going to fire people. And so I guess there are a lot of people out there who support him. 57% of white Americans voted for Donald Trump.
Isn't that amazing?
It's hard to believe. Despite COVID, despite the mismanagement of COVID, despite his threat to U.S. national security, despite the fact that he really hasn't done anything for working class Americans, that tax cut did not go to ordinary people, and yet 57% of white Americans voted for him. This is a significant issue for America, and he's compounding the troubles we have now by trying to knock off the top of our national security apparatus. When we need these people in office to do an orderly transition.
Well, let me ask you then. So, you know, we learned tonight that the intel community isn't briefing President-elect Biden on national security issues because of the holdup of the transition by the GSA. That seems like a huge problem.
It is a problem. But on the other hand, President-elect Biden has the most experienced group of people there that have ever been part of a transition.
Thank you for making my point that I made earlier. Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you for, I think that's going to help. But listen, we have to continue to point out just how absurd what the current administration is doing. But the fact that he has good people around him and he has that experience, that's going to help. And people should at least take some solace in that, right?
Absolutely. Look, these people have all been in the Obama administration. They've all held top positions. Tony Blinken, Susan Rice, Michelle Flournoy, they're first-rate people. They're right up at the top. Of course, the military is still there. And the thing about it is these people have only been away from government, most of them for 4 years. They know these military leaders. Mm-hmm. They know the intelligence people at the near the top of the agency. So it's not the right way to do a transition. But if there was ever a time that a president-elect can handle it, it's President-elect Biden and his team.